worship you.
Everything's okay and everything's alright, 'cause I got Jesus in my life.
hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the storm, He is Lord, Lord of all. When darkness seems to hide His face, I rest on His unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the storm, He is Lord, Lord of all. He is Lord, Lord of all. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the storm, He is Lord, Lord of all, Lord of all.
Hello, church. Welcome to Sunday worship. The weather has been very strange lately, don't you guys think? It was really cold in the morning, and all of a sudden it gets really super hot in the afternoon. One day I was wearing a thick jacket and a boots, and after a little while I was drenched in sweat because it was so hot. Man, I wish I had the power to predict the future. Don't you all wish that you guys have the power to predict the future? Well, let me tell you guys a secret. Come here. Come closer. I can predict the future. No, really. You don't believe me?
Nope.
You don't?
Nope.
Well, follow this simple instruction, the direction, and it will prove that I can tell the future. Now, in this paper, in a paper, I wrote down a number. Actually, I'll just do it with my hand. And you'll tell me this number after a short activity. Are you guys ready? Now, let's do this. Everyone, take out a paper. And I have my hand ready right here with the finger. How many? And on that paper, pick a number from 1 to 9. Write down a number between 1 and 9. Okay? And now with the number that you pick, multiply that number by 2. and add 10 to the total. Are you guys done? Ready? Now, divide the number by 2. You got it? Now, from this number, subtract the number that you guys picked at first. And the number should be 5! Ta-da! Is 5 your number? See? I can predict the future! Just kidding. This is just a simple math trick everyone can do. But wouldn't it be nice, everyone, if we can actually tell the future? Hey, church, don't you want to hear something cool? We know God's plan for all humanity, which means that we kind of know part of the future. We know that Jesus will one day come back, return, and free believers from suffering and judge the wicked. That is the promise that God has made. In today's lesson, Paul wrote a letter to people in Thessalonica and gave them hope in the midst of their suffering. Paul's passion was to spread the good news of Jesus Christ. So Paul, he traveled to different places and also wrote many, many letters to spread the gospel and also to encourage other believers to stay strong in their faith. About 20 years after Jesus died on the cross and rose again, Paul went to the city called Thessalonica. Paul told many people in Thessalonica the good news about Jesus Christ. Do you guys remember what the good news, the gospel is? Gospel is the good news that God the Father has sent His Son, Jesus Christ, to this world to forgive sins and draw sinful people into His kingdom. Jesus lived a perfect life and died a death that we all deserve and rose again to save those who will follow Him. People in Thessalonica believed in false idols. Some even worshiped the Roman emperor. So Paul shared the good news to people, and many people came to believe in Jesus Christ. And Paul started the church there. But there was a slight problem there.
Who does he think he is? I don't like his teaching. Get out! Get out of our town!
Some did not like Paul and his teachings, so they forced Paul out of their city. Although people were mean to Paul, he worried about the people there. Many were new believers, and Paul wanted them to stay strong in their faith. So Paul sent his dear friend Timothy to see how they were doing. And Timothy, he brought back good news. He said,
even though believers there are suffering, they're not giving up, doing a very good job.
Paul was thankful. He was very happy, so he wrote to believers to encourage them to stay strong in faith. Paul wrote and said that believers will be free from their suffering. This message gave believers great hope. Paul wrote and taught them that because of what Jesus did on the cross for us, and because what will happen to us at the end, we can grieve with hope. The Bible tells us that one day Jesus Christ will return, and when He does, all believers, whether dead or alive, will all be raised up together to meet the Lord. We will live with God forever in heaven. So with this hope. We can be hopeful in the midst of suffering. Have you guys ever looked forward to go somewhere or to meet someone that you really like? Do you guys remember how that feels? Now, just like that, I pray that you guys would look forward to the day that we will all reunite, meet with Jesus. No one knows when Jesus will come again. The Bible tells us that Jesus will come like a thief in the night when you do not expect it. So be ready. Some people might pretend and try to trick people and say, I know when this world will end. But let's not fall into their trick. Only God knows when Jesus will return. And when he does, believers will raise up to live forever with God in heaven. Some of you guys may ask, now, how do we even get ready? We need to continue to spend time with Jesus, believe and share that Jesus Christ is Lord. Remember God's truth and grow in faith. When we go through suffering, remember that because of what will happen at the end and because we know that our Creator God is with us, we have hope in the midst of suffering. Let's take this time and say thank you to our God. Let's pray. Thank you, God, for sending Jesus to us. Thank you that we are your precious children. Help us to remember your promise and live a life that is pleasing in your eyes. Help us to have hope for our future and share that hope to everyone we meet. In your precious Son's name we pray. Amen. Well, that's it for today, boys and girls, and I'll see you guys next time. But before I let you guys go, we are all going to say the Lord's Prayer together. So put your hands together, close your eyes, and let's say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.